I've often described him as somebody who was like a gunslinger in the Old West, but when he strapped the Fender on, he was unassailable. It brought a whole kind of dynamism and a magic to the way, because he was just so in tune with that instrument.
Yeah, it was just, you know, Rory Gallagher was his guitar.
The way he finds his way around the guitar, it's just, it's a wonderful, wonderful thing to behold.
It was just like watching a real craftsman. You know, this wasn't a guitarist, this was a craftsman at work. It felt like there wasn't anything he couldn't do on this guitar, just like he knew this guitar inside out, and it was just like...
You'll often find that with guitarists, they look at a guitar and think, well, if I played that, I could get a sound out of it. But of course, for somebody to lift up Rory's Strat and try and play it and get the same sound out of it that Rory got, just absolutely impossible.
So many guitarists, they play the classic style of just playing the chords and then just turn it up for the solo and then back down for just playing the chords. But Rory did so much more with the guitar. The guitar summed up for me, you know, you couldn't have got a better match for Rory than this guitar. And I think Rory knew that.
The Strat has almost, well, it has become the thing of legends. I mean, it's a beautiful machine. The signature replicas have obviously gone like hotcakes.
To me, it just sort of summed up the whole of Rory's attitude. The whole of Rory, this is. This happened naturally from all that hard wear and, you know, just living and breathing it. Just pure music, pure brilliance.
Rory's music still lives on to this day through the number of tribute bands dedicated to preserving the memory of this unique guitar player.
My lifelong hero, Rory Gallagher, died in 1995, and I was determined to do something to commemorate his life. So I decided to put on a little tribute gig, and then what happened is Rory Gallagher tribute band started coming out of the woodwork, and I became one of them. And now we've got this place at Duckyfield Town Hall we come to every year to do this gig, and we bring bands from Germany and Spain and Ireland over, and then we go over to their gigs in Holland and Ireland and stuff, and we have a really good time. The guitar sound is a very difficult thing to create. You'll notice tonight we're using very authentic equipment, Fender Stratocasters and Vox AC30s, which are prone to blowing up, but we can't use modern digital amps because they sound crap, they don't sound like Rory, you know, and it's got to be loud, which sometimes the sound men get irritated by. But yeah, we go as close as we can, as close as we can. Nobody will ever get there completely because most of it was in his fingers anyway. He was an absolute genius.
Black slapper, that pistol in your face.
Because it's sort of simple kind of music, in a sense, you know? That's the beauty of it, it's still rawness. It's also very rhythmic. I mean, the acoustic style of blues, electric, you can develop, you know, in other sort of directions, you know?
Rock music went through a terrible pop, glittery culture for a while, and I think, I'm glad to see, I think lots of people picked up on Rory's music because of the gutsy honesty of it.
As the crow flies, baby, well, I ain't so far from you.
Rory's music was recognised by fans and artists alike, and in 1972 he won the Melody Maker Musician of the Year Award.
To be in the same company in 1972 as Jimmy Page and Eric Clapton, and for Rory to be topping that poll, that was a proud moment for anybody who's Irish. And a lot of people remembered him for that too, was the fact that he gave them great pride. I think anybody in this country who picked up a guitar after Rory would have been inspired by Gallagher. I mean, when you think of it, fellas named their women and guys named their children after him. That is kind of, you know, says a lot. When you have somebody who inspires you that much, then you want your call, you know, you want to call your child after him, not Dweezil Zappa or Moon Unit, you know, O'Callaghan.
Even 12 years after his death, Rory's music is still admired by fans and fellow musicians.
Well, you can ride on the precipice of a wave if that's where you want to be. But doesn't look good.